With the recent announcement of the Moto Z and the Moto Z Force, I figured it was time to dust off my old Droid Turbo 2 and do the teardown. It's been a while since I did my durability test on it, so let's get started. First thing, turn off the phone, and then pop out the SIM card tray from the top using your SIM card ejector tool. And sometimes there's a little hole in the top of the Motorola phones where you can push the back plate out with the little SIM card tool, but not in this one. So we're going to use a little bit of heat to heat up the back and soften the adhesive. It really does help having a little bit of heat on there. But we're not trying to melt the back, so make sure not to get it too hot. I'm going to use a little bit of brute force and a razor blade to start removing the back panel. It's not too difficult since the adhesive is already warmed up a little bit. Once I get my tool under there, I can just lift it up and peel it away from the back. I'll take special care not to hurt the wireless charging. I'll hold it down with my hands as I pull the back away so it doesn't get bent or torn at all. I will link all the replacement parts and tools down in the video description of this video. I'm using a T4 bit, but with Chinese tools the bits can vary a little bit with each set. Some people say a T3 works better. I'm going to unclip these two cables underneath the rubber pads. One is for the wireless charging and the other is for the vibrator motor and headphone jack that you'll see in a second. There are 17 screws around that back side. Remove all those. And then the front screen and motherboard will pop away from that back panel. Here you can see the wireless charging, as well as the ribbon cable for the headphone jack, the vibrator, and the flash for the camera. The loudspeaker is down here at the bottom as well. It has two little contact points for the motherboard. There's some black tape over the battery. I'm just going to remove this and put it off to the side. Try to keep it in one piece so you can reuse it later, but if it gets torn, it's not too big of a deal. This stuff's not meant to come off easy. There are two screws holding on this metal bracket. I think this is a fantastic idea. It kind of sandwiches the motherboard between two pieces of metal, making the phone way more rigid than it normally would be. I'm going to unclip the battery. Then there's a piece of gold tape over this ribbon cable connector. I'm going to unlatch the end of it and that'll unlock the ribbon so it can be pulled away from the motherboard. And then this one's more like a Lego. Just going to unsnap that from the mainboard and pull it off to the side. Then there's a little extension microphone ribbon down here at the bottom. I'm going to remove the battery using my metal pry tool, taking very special care not to puncture or slice the battery as I pry up on it. It is very important that you do not puncture the battery during this process. A little bit of heat would help as well, but the battery just pops out on its own. Now the screen ribbon cable is on the upper side of the motherboard as well. There's this little tiny latch that I lifted up and then I can slide this little tiny circuit board off of the main board with my plastic pry tool. And that releases the motherboard from the frame of the screen. There's one more wire cable at the left side of the phone as well that I'm going to unsnap. And the front facing camera unsnaps like a little Lego from the extension ribbon cable. The front-facing camera is 5 megapixels and sits right here attached to this extension ribbon cable that also houses the power button, the volume button, and the little contact points. The rear 21 megapixel camera is also removable. It sits right here on the motherboard with the same latch type connector. The SIM card tray is not removable. It is soldered onto the board as well as the charging port and this little extension microphone thing that we got going on down here. Who knows what that's for? So this is the screen. The LCD panel sits inside the plastic and metal frame, and it is impossible to remove without breaking it, so I'm not going to do it in this video. But the replacement screens only come with the LCD and the plastic shatter shield thing that Motorola's got going on. So you do have to remove it from the plastic frame using heat and a pry tool. I'll link all the replacement screens down in the video description. Just remember that if you do have to separate the LCD from the frame, it's going to sacrifice your LCD in the process, so only attempt it if you have nothing left to lose. Reassembling the phone, putting the front camera back into its little slot and clipping it down onto that extension ribbon, and then setting the motherboard down into place and clipping down that wire cable. Making sure that this bottom extension mic is stuck down into place where it should be. The screen ribbon also gets plugged in, the top portion at least. Then making sure that gold tape is set back down on top as well. And that just keeps it from unlatching in the future if you ever drop your phone. I'm going to latch the rest of the screen ribbon into place, put the gold tape back down on top of that as well. Now, if you just want to replace your shatter shield screen, just that top plastic layer, I do have a video for that as well. I will link that here. It's a lot cheaper than replacing the whole screen itself. Battery's in place, clip that down onto the motherboard, and then we'll put that supporting metal bracket back into place as well with the two screws on it. Same size screws as all the rest of them, but they are different lengths, so make sure you keep your screws organized. The back plastic housing is going to be clamped down onto the screen frame. Press that into place all around the outside and get those 17 screws back into place along with the rubber caps for those two ribbon cables. Back panel gets set down into place as well, and it actually went on surprisingly well. considering that I just took it off. The adhesive that was left remaining on the back panel was actually enough to keep it into place. If I hadn't done my durability test on this phone, you wouldn't be able to tell it's been opened in the past. Turn it on, make sure everything's good. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video and want to see others like it in the future, hit that subscribe button. It does help me out a lot. As always, Twitter and Instagram are great for behind the scenes and other projects I have going on. Thanks a ton for watching. I really do appreciate it. Hope to see you around.